Let's refactor an ES5 React app to ES6. First of all, what's ES5 and ES6? ECMAScript, abbreviated as ES, is the official standard for JavaScript. ES5 and ES6 are simply different versions or specifications of the language. But like JSX, certain syntax may not be supported by browsers, which is why it's useful to have a plugin that can compile the code. Let's do that first. Go to your terminal and run npm install babel preset es2015. This babel preset only compiles es2015 to es5. To use other specifications, feel free to download the respective preset. Once it's done, open server.js and add the es2015 preset to babel register. Save the file, open webpack.config.js. Add the preset here as well. If you don't add it, the client bundle won't compile properly. And don't forget to restart or rerun Webpack. Now open view/layout.jsx. Refactor the common JS required to ES6 import. Here, you're importing the default and assigning it to React. But to import a member, you'll need to wrap the exact name in curly braces. Do the same for this line as well. Now instead of React.create class, you can create a class that extends React.component. But just so you know, a JavaScript class is just syntactical sugar over the existing prototypal inheritance model. Make sure to close a class with a single curly brace. Method definitions within classes can be refactored to a shorter syntax. Also, make sure to remove the trailing comma at the end of the method. You can use the destructuring assignment to extract custom from this.props. Const is a block-scoped read-only reference to the value. Although the variable identifier can't be reassigned, it doesn't mean the value itself is immutable. In other words, you can think of const declaration as a one-time assignment. The arrow function is a shorthand of the function expression. Instead of binding to its own this scope, it binds to the parents. Like import, you can refactor to ES6 export and use the default type. Just so you know, there can only be one default export per module. Save the file, open view/index.jsx. Refactor the required to import. Also, since our component is presentational, we can refactor it to a stateless function. If you expect props in your stateless component, then you can access it in the first argument. Save the file, open view/about.jsx. Make a refactor similar to index component. Now when I go back to the browser and refresh, I get an error. You might not get this error if you're using Babel 6. When Babel originally transformed to CommonJS modules, it appended the default key to exports. To fix this, open the file that requires the view components, which is route/routes.jsx. Then append .default to the required modules that use ES6 export syntax. Save the file, go back to the browser, and refresh the page. You'll see that the error is gone. Of course, a simpler solution is to use import instead of require. So let's do that. Since we're here, let's refactor the require to import on top. To import multiple members, just separate them by a comma. Save the file, open view/layout.jsx, since there's one more caveat about standing a React class. For custom class methods, React doesn't automatically bind the this scope like React.create class does. Thus, you'll need to bind them, and one place to do that is in the special constructor method. First, you'll need to call super in order to initialize this. Then bind the proper context to the handleClick method. Save the file and go back to the browser. Refresh the page and then click the button. You should be able to see the title in the alert. This covers just some of the ES6 features, so feel free to explore the rest. And that goes over a basic ES5 to ES6 React refactor.